The Air Force is fast-tracking new fighter jets with a lot of new tech, but will they have what it takes to beat China and Russia? Welcome to America Uncovered, I'm Chris Chappell. Top Gun Maverick is breaking box office records. Clearly, it's because people want to see Tom Cruise come to a deeper sense of self-acceptance while confronting the ghosts of his past. Or it's because they want to watch Tom Cruise fly an F-18. Although Cruise wasn't actually allowed to fly a $70 million fighter jet, because the Pentagon is not insane. But the real Top Gun school that inspired the movies is about training elite fighter pilots and maintaining U.S. air superiority. But there are questions about whether the U.S. can maintain its air superiority in the decades ahead, especially over China, which is something the Pentagon is worried about. U.S. Air Force leaders have warned that the U.S. will lose its air superiority to China without rapid change. And the Air Force is willing to change some pretty big things. The Pentagon is at work on at least 2 sixth-generation fighter jets. This next generation of advanced fighter jets will be even more powerful than the current fifth-generation F-35 stealth aircraft and the F-22 stealth tactical fighters. These new jets are at the centerpiece of the Pentagon's next-generation Air Dominance Fighter Program, or NGAD. Now, there's been a lot of progress since the Air Force first began experimental prototyping in 2015. In 2020, the Air Force flew a prototype that set records. And things seem to be going so well that the Air Force is actually fast-tracking the NGAD by moving into a critical new phase, engineering, manufacturing, and development.
We have now started on the EMD program to do the development aircraft. We think we'll have capability by the end of the decade.
By the end of the decade. So 2030, that's 8 years away. Which is actually fast for the Air Force. But is it fast enough?
I have a sense of urgency about getting new capabilities, and I'm willing to take some risk there. So we are in a race for technological superiority.
The United States' competitive edge over China and even Russia is shrinking. And that's saying something, since Russia hasn't exactly impressed the world with its military lately. In some cases, Russia and China are even beating the U.S., especially with hypersonic missiles.
But Russia isn't just testing these weapons. It just became the first country to ever actually use hypersonic weapons in war, using them at least 10 times in Ukraine, according to the Pentagon.
Well, it's a consequential weapon.
And China successfully tested a hypersonic weapon that orbited the globe last year.
I'll have more about how the U.S. is responding to this hypersonic missile threat in another episode. But missiles aren't the only thing the U.S. will have to worry about. China's already trying to take away America's advantage in stealth technology, an advantage the U.S. has had for decades. And China is building its own sixth-generation stealth fighter and drone fleets. If America's next fighter jet wants to stay ahead, it needs some really advanced features. I'll tell you what those are after the break. Welcome back. China and Russia are developing new technologies to bridge the military gap with the U.S., but the U.S. is trying to stay ahead of the curve with the NGAD fighter jet program. Not many details about the fighter jets are known yet. We don't even exactly know who is manufacturing them. But there are 4 key features that Air Force leaders say the new secret fighter jets will need to defeat America's enemies. Let's start with number 1, longer range and speed. Up until now, the Air Force has been focused on countering Russia in Europe. Europe isn't exactly that big. Fighter jets from U.S. bases don't have to travel that far. But the Pacific is a whole nother ballpark. There's a lot more distance to cover. And with China getting antsy, it probably won't be too long before U.S. jets need to travel longer distances fast. That's why the Air Force says there could be 2 versions of the sixth-generation fighter jet, one for Russia and another for China. Anyway, it's only just now that the Air Force is designing a fighter specifically for the Pacific. Lieutenant General David Noholm said, "We've never developed a fighter with the ranges of the Pacific in mind before." So this would be a first. And it's about time with all the moves that China has been making in the Indo-Pacific. These fighter jets could also be powered by next-generation engines with more range, greater acceleration, and increased cooling, thanks to the Advanced Engine Transition Program. But even that will require more fuel to cover longer distances fast. So if next-generation fighter jets want to maintain stealth and fly farther, then they're going to have to be larger and carry more missiles and fuel. Which leads to my next point. Number two, new stealth technologies. America's enemies are already improving their stealth detection technology. We're already seeing advanced sensors starting to overcome the current F-22's radar evading stealth. Which isn't too surprising, the F-22 and F-35 stealth technology is based on 1990s and even 1980s designs. Adding new upgrades can only go so far. It's like Madonna. She keeps trying to add new upgrades, but she can only go so far before things get weird. But the fact that China and Russia are starting to overcome US stealth tech is one reason why the F-22 could be retired by 2030. Next generation fighter jets are already working to fix the stealth problem. Industry insiders say NGAD will be orders of magnitude harder to detect than even current fighter jets. But who knows how long it'll take until China and Russia find a way. New air defense systems and missile technology are threatening to make America's stealth fleets obsolete. However, the US could still make up for that. I'll tell you how after this final commercial break. Welcome back. America's sixth generation fighter jets will have to cover more distance to counter China in the Pacific, and they'll have to do it as stealthily as possible. But China's range and detection technology is improving. The US may have to beat them with more than just better missiles, engines, and stealth. Which leads to the NGAD priority number three, drone swarms and AI. NGAD is more than just a fighter jet. According to Air Force Secretary Kendall, NGAD is envisioned to be a family of systems. This means both the Air Force and Navy's new fighter jets will work together with other military hardware, including drones. The US has been experimenting with drone swarms for a while now. What's great is that they can overwhelm targets with sheer numbers at relatively low cost. But that's also an advantage for Russia and China. China knows how useful drones are. And like everything America produces, China makes its own copycat versions. China's already working on drones that can be launched by air and by sea. Knowing China, they'll definitely use civilian drone makers with military ties against us. Like their new, supposedly AI-powered drone mothership. Yes, that's a drone ship filled with more drones. Yep, that is totally a civilian ship with no military applications. But China's drone warfare is why the US military will need drones to fight fire with fire. US drones could have countermeasures like directed energy weapons. Finally, drones with lasers. And they can be powered by AI and machine learning to outperform the Chinese military. This could save the US a lot of money in the long run, because the new fighter jets aren't going to be cheap. To give you a comparison, the F-35A costs around $80 million each. And at that cost, it's been frequently called a boondoggle. Well, each NGAD fighter jet will cost more than double that. However, the US might not need as many of them since each fighter jet will be working with a bunch of drones. And losing drones will be a lot more affordable. This leads to number four. Better production. That may not sound exciting, but it's actually huge. It's totally different from the way the Pentagon usually operates. Let's take the F-35s. One reason they're so expensive is that they're made to last for over 60 years. That means the US spends almost $1.3 trillion just to maintain the F-35s for that long. Yeah, most of that boondoggle isn't just about building the F-35s, but keeping them going. Things are going to be different with the NGAD fighters. The Air Force is shifting away from building thousands of fighters that last half a century to only 50 or 100 fighters that last just 12 to 15 years. The idea is that it keeps the US up to date in the long run. Instead of having one awesome fighter jet that's supposed to last forever, you have one awesome fighter jet that's supposed to last for a little while and then be replaced with another awesome fighter jet. It's like getting a new iPhone every 2 years. Hey, it's got a better camera. The goal is to avoid getting stuck for decades on a project that could end up becoming obsolete. Instead, NGAD could go on for decades with a whole series of different fighters being churned out as the Air Force crams new modular systems. With China especially developing weapons at such a high speed, the U.S. needs to develop technology faster and get that tech out quicker. Like, probably before 2030. So what do you think? Let us know in the comments below. And we could not make this show without support from viewers like you. You can help us for as little as a dollar per episode at patreon.com/AmericaUncovered. Or on our exclusive censorship-free social media platform, AmericaUncovered.locals.com. The links to both are in the description below. Once again, I'm Chris Chappell. Thanks for watching America Uncovered.